drink from. Does anybody have any questions about your work? About your work or your creative thing going on? How are people doing? How you doing, Curtis? And did you ever find that hat last week that I ran in the report on the street? Is that it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Simple.
Get it.
St. Mark's.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to haggle them down.
That's great. It's great to like go out looking for a cap when you found it.
Yeah.
That's really cool. Yeah. You get all your caps from
either I find them on the street or I go to some
street,
place like
on the ground.
I'm not gonna lie. Washing machines work.
Wash.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I know. But yeah.
I mean, you know. I might have been wearing them before.
Oh. Okay. So, anybody have any questions for Tom Craig?
Yeah.
Oh. What's happening? I was just thinking, like, when you just extended.
Yeah.
That was really interesting.
Yeah.
Because time was flying by.
Right. I'll just do this.
unaccessible. It was just a way of doing it, you know, in the way a hobby audience may. But so as an artist who's creating something beautiful, how do you approach that? I will say I used to be karate a long time ago. And my teacher, whose name is Kaichun Nakamura, would say, he's like a 90th degree black belt. He has so many stripes on his belt, and he's like been doing karate forever. He would stand there and say, there is no opponent. So he would be standing in front of you. Big guy. All his stripes on the back. There is no opponent. So I would suggest, because what are you going to do? Start tap dancing, hoping they're going to like him. Maybe they don't like tap dancing, you know? So there is no opponent. Don't sweat that. But I promise, if you do the best work that you can, specific to the work, the play that you have, then you're going to win. You're going to win, because you're going to win the prize of, we did awesome work. And we have created a great relationship. We've got a great relationship with your writer. I'm sure it's an awesome and fun play. Do your best work. Don't sweat the votes or anything like that. Whatever. You know what I'm saying? So don't worry about it. So just, you know, talk to the playwright about her goals, what she wants for her piece. Talk to her. If you have any questions, even if they seem stupid, you know, or dumb, ask her anyway. Get into a relationship where she feels like she can just say anything. Okay? And then go from there. And don't sweat that for her. I mean, like it's like when we do theater, like at the public theater. We're not, you know, I mean, sure the producers are concerned about reviews and whatnot, but I'm not sitting there going, oh, I have to change something so that people will like it more. But you know, you change it to make the piece better, but not so that people will like it more. People, millions of people all over the world are going to see it. Okay. But have fun too. To keep you posted.
Please go ahead.
So I'm working on this other project.
The man of many projects.
Job that you have chosen and the job that has chosen you. Just like writers, we have to, if you're more traditional, we have to do a lot of the heavy lifting on our own. You know, unless you're doing devised work in a room full of people and everybody's contributing. But step back from that and you're doing a lot of heavy lifting on your own. And you have to let her do that. You know, otherwise she's going to become one of those writers who needs a group of people around her just to help her get something on the page. And unless you're doing devised work, that's not a good relationship. That's not a good thing to do.
You know, you gotta learn how to be, I mean, like a human being. You have to learn how to be a lover. Which is hard. Which is not real.
Right.
But it always does, right? That we always do. That's a good question. And great, you're very exciting. Keep us posted. But in a way, it kind of is. He was sent there because of what he believed in. She went there because of what she believed in. You know, that's your life, that's your calling, it was called for the world. You know? And yeah, you have to go inside, like you said. You have to go inside so that you can take it to the streets. You have to. Unless, there are lots of ways to work, and lots of people work different ways, and I'm not discounting other ways to work. There's plenty of, we all know, great groups that work collaboratively. And they're awesome and lovely. And for those of us who also work in the more traditional way, I'm sitting in the room alone. You have to deal with the fact that you're alone. Are you a writer? Yes. You're alone. You're alone. Writing. Alone. It's hard. It's really hard. We know. We do it. It's really difficult. And so maybe the next time we're having a hard time, we don't have to go and be an asshole to yourself. Knucklehead, you loser, kicking yourself, you're having a hard time. Hey, I'm having a hard time because it's hard. It's really hard. I was just meeting a fabulous theater director who wants me to work with him today. We just met a couple hours ago. And then told him all the things I was doing. And he pulled back and he said, oh, he's from a foreign land. Oh, and what you do is make it. And I said, what do you mean? It's what I do. I fabricate. He said, that, but you're like, no. You know, you're alone. So, I have a couple of thoughts. One, tunneling, you know, sometimes when we're working, we feel like we're tunneling toward our work. You know, we're tunneling, and it's very hard. You're in the ground and you're digging. And you feel very lost and it's dark and it's cold. You wonder if the walls are going to collapse in on you. Know that your work is tunneling for you. Those people or ideas, whatever you get into, you know, I work with characters primarily, but some people work with ideas and concepts. Those people in my case are tunneling toward you. They're digging furiously toward you, and they'll dig as hard as you do, and they won't stop. And if you stop, they're going to stop. But if you start digging, they're going to start digging too. They're going to continue digging. So just know that. Also, I was thinking today about creating space, because that's a lot of what we have to do in order to work. We have to create space, right? Sometimes it's just like a table, you know, you got to have a place to work, like a physical space. Sometimes it's time in your day that you have to figure out, who am I going to write, or what am I going to do my thing, right? Sometimes it's very important to work to create space, whether it's physical space, space in your head. Sometimes if there are things going on in your environment, that's why. If any whatever needs to be this bin here, is full of earplugs. So if you ever need any, if we're sitting here and we're working and, you know, they're too excited down there in anticipation of the great shows that they're going to see, come get some earplugs, and you can come and have earplugs. You can create space in your head. Sometimes it's also important to create space. Your work needs somewhere to be after it's done. You know, it's going to produce you somewhere. It helps get that you're going to hand your work off to a group instead of everything. It's going to, you know, see it has somewhere to go. It's very important. Creation of space is a very important ingredient to the successful creation of your work. Creating silence also is a way to create space. So I just started thinking about that. That's what I did a lot this week. I was creating a lot of space and thinking, come on.
I also find that work creates a lot of clutter. You know, what do you say to I tend to say it's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, because I know that one is so I'll need it as
well. Right. Yeah, what do you say to work creates a lot of clutter, which is why I'm talking about space. Because working creates a lot of clutter. You buy books or research, even if you buy them online, even if you wrote down them on Kindle or your iPad. Still is a lot of clutter, a lot of saved documents. Just save the documents. Get really good at saving your documents. If you print out stuff, you know, get an extra file on that. There's also creating space means that maybe you're going to have to call to give something up. Which is, you know, maybe you're going to have to give up, I don't know, going jogging for 3 hours every single morning. You know, maybe you only go twice a week. Three times a week, or maybe you don't go at all for the month of December because you're working. That's okay. Those are the kind of things you realize when you say, I'm going to give that up for a moment. You know? So maybe you have to buy a new filing cabinet, which means maybe you have to give up that space that was devoted to that whatever and put that thing in storage and get yourself a filing board. Buy a storage unit and load it with your graphs and things. Yeah, but sometimes you have to say, I gotta get something up to get this thing done. Or at least to give myself an opportunity to get it done. I know. It's getting real now.
I finished a long seminar.
Right.
I don't know. Everything's so hard, but each seems like it's different challenges. Each seems hard in a different way.
Right.
Different tones, different sort of things coming out.
Right.
I don't know. The scene I'm working on right now, it's more than anything else in the whole play. I actually have to make it up by scratch, because for most of the play I know what beats I have to hit
right.
In each scene. But for this one, because I made my first score like a year ago,
right.
Knowing that the scene's gonna be here, then I got here, they're so old, there's just nothing coming off of them. So I realized I'm gonna put them all out and just like completely from scratch. And so I every time someone speaks, I really have to figure out what they want to say and why they're saying
it. Is it hard to do it that way?
Yeah,
it's hard to have to write it to scratch. He's saying that he's got to, you know, who made notes, but they're old notes now, so they're not really appropriate, you know, for what he's doing now, so you got to kind of make it from scratch. Can you make new notes just to get you through the scene?
Well, yeah, I'm starting to, but it's, but for, I don't know, just for the most part, I'm still seeing blank walls more than seeing connections.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it varies, but I try to put at least 3 hours into it. So, yeah.
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 So you've made notes for this, because you're not going blind. Because sometimes, say you have, like, you're on a journey and you have a book and you think it's great, and you pull it out of your bag and the book's all free because it's been in there for 10 years. You're like, that's not going to work. So what do you do? You don't go, well, we'll just try to make it without the rope. Look around and see if there's something, you know, fashion a rope out of something else. Go ahead and give yourself some notes if notice is right. Can you sketch out some notes just to give yourself a kind of...
Yeah, I mean, I already have, but they're not yet coming together the way that, like, with me, the way it's coming up in the sort of general... I thought it was really good, and I, you know, I showed it around, I had it workshopped.
Okay.
People loved it. People
right.
loved it, and some people told me that it was like one of the greatest things they've ever seen. And like I got a lot of this kind of feedback, and so after a while I started to get scared of it. Like, that's it. I'm never going to live up to that piece of writing again. And so finding this character's voice again is like I can't fucking live up to. Stellar piece of work that I did back.
Right.
Yeah.
That's why getting bad reviews, getting great reviews is like
dangerous.
Yeah. So there's no way. You get a bad review, you don't want to write again. You get a great review, you don't want to write again. There's no remedy except to continue. So, you know, I mean, that's a great problem to have. I'm sorry that you were praised so much for your writing to that. And I find it difficult. But could you set like a kind of a deadline for post that scene?
I guess I could. I mean, I'd like to finish the scene in a few weeks.
A few weeks. Okay. How many pages?
I mean, it'll be about
10 pages. So 10 pages in 2 weeks, like 3 weeks? You come back next time and check it.
Yeah,
right. Just like hearing the phrase. Anybody else recording? We have like 5 seconds. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
I'm thinking next year, 2014, we'll change it back to Wednesday. So if anybody like hates the idea of doing that,
hi, how are you?
I'm so good. I know it's good.